A picture is worth a thousand words. And in the digital era, a picture is worth millions of pixels, telling the stories of 8 billion humans and reflecting infinite shades of emotions. Vivo presents a celebration of visual storytelling and the power of human imagination. The Vivo Imagine journey began with the grand launch of the campaign by a weaver of stories, a traveler of worlds, a creator of cinema, the acclaimed filmmaker Zoya Akhtar, who announced the open call for all those emerging talents from across the nation who look through lenses and imagine stories.
Vivo smartphone invites you to live the joy and share these moments of joy with the world.
As soon as the campaign was kicked off, the inboxes began to buzz and the servers began to fill up with thousands of entries from every nook and corner of the nation. Snapshots of vivid imagination from talent of every age, from perspective of every kind. Even going through so many entries and then judging the best among them was going to be a superhuman task. And for that, we chose the perfect trio, the Vivographers. These three maestros of visual storytelling chose the finest images according to their philosophy of what makes for a truly great photograph.
Hello everyone, my name is Dheeraj Juneja, and on behalf of Vivo, I'm absolutely delighted to welcome you all to the Vivo Imagine Smartphone Photography Awards finale. And you know, it's a good cue to the claps. But before we move forward with the awards, I would now request someone very special from Vivo to please take the stage. Please welcome, with a round warm of applause, Mr. Karun Arora, GM Marketing Communication, Vivo India.
We want to take smartphone photography to a different level altogether. And that's the purpose we have, you know. That's the joy we get for our consumers, you know. So to give them the best of the camera, the best of technology. That's the excitement you have when you see your consumers engaging with you, you know, in a way and showcasing such a great work, yeah. So thank you so much once again, yeah.
I request Vineet, Rakesh, Amir and Zoya to please be on the stage. It's time for the felicitation.
For better or worse, our phones are now an extension of our bodies. And the camera is a part of it. And I like the fact that Vivo has pushed people to flip it from their own face and their selfie and kind of turn it around onto the world and show us what they see.
From the minute you start entering or submitting an entry, you're a winner there because you're putting your heart and soul into that image.
Photography is, for me, it's an art of observation. How you look at things and how you see them and then how you showcase it to the world.
For photography, it's all about research. So I always say research, research, research. Even before I go, I try to pre-visualize my output. I just keep asking, how can I make it my own, like my perspective? How can I show the viewer in my point of view?
I feel photography is extremely inspiring. Photography freezes a moment in time, and that moment is come and gone. And when there's truth in that moment, if somebody's captured truth in that moment, then it's forever preserved.
The campaign entries were divided into broad categories, reflecting the sheer range of visual storytelling displayed in them. Nature. Motion. Portrait, culture, night, and architecture.
The other three jurors did all the heavy lifting because there were more than 21,000 entries.
And also when we were looking at entries, well, there were parameters for sure, which we were keeping in mind, which was composition techniques, originality, and the POV. And any image which kind of held my attention for more than 3 seconds, I think that is the picture.
I'll ask myself as a photographer, could I have done it better? When I see something like that, I just think it's a great picture.
Composition is what makes or breaks the photograph for me.
But also that whether I see the photographer in it or not.
You look at a picture, and if you see more than meets the eye, I think that's what's a great image.
End of the day, it's always the heart that wins over the mind when it comes to a photograph.
as the juries got busy with the intense process of judging the entries, the team of tech wizards at Vivo got busy creating a grand website on which all of the entries were featured, a treasure trove for enthusiasts of photography to visit and browse through, a showcase and archive of all the visual stories received.
You know, because it's very important to for them to understand where I need to enter and how to enter, you know. So every process we kept as simple as possible so that we get maximum love, you know, and support.
It's amazing because everyone sent in how they see the world, how they see culture, how they see the night, how they see art, architecture. It's very interesting to see a different point of view.
And when I was looking at so many viewpoints, it was a different kind of a challenge for us. I was looking at how a person is reading a moment differently.
There's a great variety in it, you know, seeing pictures in different categories in different parts of India thanks to Vivo Imagine Smartphone Photography Awards.
The finalists completed the masterclass, armed with smart tips and tricks and refreshed with new perspectives. But then, as the old proverb goes, when all learning is done by the student, it is time for battle between the warriors. The finalists would compete for the grand prizes of the Vivo Imagine Awards.
This finale is the culmination of a truly remarkable campaign that was specially designed to celebrate and elevate the art of smartphone photography. Our first category is portrait, where the essence of individuals and their stories come to life. And the winner is Prayag Samal.
My main thought process was to capture a portrait with something information about the specific tribal group, like their ornamentals, what they do, what they wear. The very specific picture I captured is from a tribal group called Gadaba. The specific type of saris he is wearing, that's called Kerang. That's very particular to that group. And the ornaments and all, those are for self-defense, because this tribe belongs from a like hunter and gatherer group. So I tried to frame that in a single frame.
In the masterclass, I spoke about portrait specifically. I think I made sure that, you know, they understand that what we are looking at is more than a face. It brings out the culture, the traditions, and of course this beautiful smile that she has on her face.
Yeah, when you're looking at this picture, you're not looking at just the face.
Yeah,
there's so many elements to read, yeah. And so, you also feel this is a good environment kind of a portrait.
Which that's what makes a good photo, right? Three of us came with seeing three things in this picture.
Correct.
So the portrait that Prayag has clicked is, again, it's not just a beautiful face, but I'm seeing a lot more happening there. You know, it didn't put the subject in the center. That was one thing. And then it's a medium shot, so you see a lot more things happening. I get a glimpse of the culture that this person is coming from and the activity that she is doing. So that is what I was looking at, and he got it. We captured it really well.
And our next category is nature. These photos invite us to embrace the wonders of the natural world, from majestic landscape to the tiniest of creatures. And the winner is Mr. Prakash Karupandan.
That's the name of Kolukumalai. That's one of the most beautiful places in Kerala. So, in the competition, I came to the end of the mile. So, I went to the flight to the airport. I went to the shots. But I had a chance to win. That's why I went to win.
So the most important thing here is the figure to ground. Apart from the landscape, we can also see the person, the human, and the connection between the human and the nature works much better.
Had this person standing maybe a little bit down or a little bit up, would have been a distracting frame.
Correct.
Yeah, and then you see there are layers in this picture, right?
Yeah.
So that makes it even more interesting. It also gave me a sense of scale, like, you know, because there's a human element to it. So exactly the same thing. He didn't try to just capture a nice landscape shot. Incorporating a human element to it, it gave it a sense of scale, which is, again, we talked about it in the masterclass, and that worked really well.
After an extensive process of judging through multiple stages, our stellar trio of Vivographers, applying their sharpest instincts, selected the finalists.
It's a great honor for me being a jury of Vivo Smartphone Photography Awards. And at the same time, it was a sweet headache, you know, choosing, because the images are impeccable. the kind of works, the theme relevance, as well as the unique perspectives people were shooting. I mean, we enjoyed thoroughly, right from the beginning to here till this moment.
When we started planning this award, so we had a lot of doubts, because this was kind of a first of a kind of, you know, thing that we were doing, and we were not expecting so many entries, and the response that we got was really overwhelming. All the jury members, we had to go through each of those entries individually and score them, and it was over 20,000 entries, so it was a, you know, big task.
There's also a kind of scare inside you that whether you're doing the right thing, you know, whether you're picking up the right entries. It was a challenging task. It was also getting the best out of the best. End of the day, we picked up images that the minute you look at them and there's ah coming out of your heart, they were picked.
I also wanted to see that originality. I didn't want to see a photograph of a beautiful human being. I mean, there's nothing wrong about it, but I wanted something more to it, not just a beautiful face. You know, that X factor shouldn't just be a nice landscape. There should be something else to it. And these guys did it really well.
I like to call myself a storyteller. And this is why I kind of aligned with this campaign, because that's what they were looking for in pictures. And like they say, a photo tells a thousand stories. And that's exactly what they were going for. It was almost like Vivo was asking people to use their camera, use their phone, and express themselves in a way to see more than meets the eye. I think that's what was interesting for me. I mean, you can look at it and there can be irony in it. There can be an emotion in it. There can be something that is more than just maybe the subject you're looking at. There's something extra that's giving you a feeling. And I think that's a great image.
Our next category is architecture. From towering skyscrapers to intricate details, these photographs take us on an inspiring journey through the world of architecture. And the winner is Murtuza Ali.
जो मैं विनर हूँ आर्किटेक्चर कैटेगरी का, उसके लिए मैं खुद मैं प्राउड करता हूँ कि मैं उन लोगों के सामने बैठा था अभी, तो मेरे लिए दिस इज अ लॉट फ्रॉम मी.
व्हाट आई लव अबाउट दिस इज इज कैप्ट इट एज सिंपल एज ही कुड, एंड आई थिंक दैट्स व्हाट्स वर्क टू बी ऑनेस्ट, दैट सिंपलिसिटी दैट ही हैज कैप्ट इंटैक्ट.
द बैलेंस इन द कंपोजिशन इज फैंटास्टिक. व्हेन यू लुक एट अ पिक्चर एंड यू कैन हियर द साउंड्स, आई कैन लिटरली हियर द फ्लैप्स of the birds. So that makes this picture outstanding. So it's static versus dynamic in the same frame. Beautiful. The kind of image that I like or resonate with is which has temporariness in it, and something which you blink and you miss and cannot be repeated. In the architecture, well, the lines were great, beautiful setting, beautiful mood, but those birds really added on that moment to it, because it is temporary and nobody else can capture that.
Our next category is culture, wherein we explore the diverse tapestry of traditions, customs, ways of life, and a whole lot more. And the winner is Shaikat Gupta.
Kusti is one of the biggest culture of our Indian history. एक old इंसान एक बच्चे के साथ कुश्ती लड़ने का कोशिश कर रहा है, वो लोग भी आगे आ रहे हैं अपने जो स्पोर्ट है हेरिटेज को आगे लाने के लिए, तो मैं वो पोर्ट्रे करने का कोशिश किया हूँ.
There's a lot happening and they're complimenting the frame.
Exactly, yeah.
I mean, it's none of them are distracting. There's a lot happening.
But I also at this point want to point out that there's a circular eye movement in this frame. You know, you look at the eyes, leads to the characters at the back and comes back and freezes here.
It's not an easy shot to compose because they are in motion. They're moving all the time. So placing himself where he, you know, got the shot from, it's not, you know, you need to have that vision that what is going to happen next and where I should, you know, place myself.
Vivo came in handy over here.
For sure. It is amazing. It's definitely one of the best pictures I've seen. It works like everything in that picture works. You see the composition, the angle, the perspective. He didn't take it from an eye level. He went, you know, down really low to the ground and shot it.
The next phase of the Vivo Imagine campaign, for the finalists to further sharpen their craft, and for the millions of aspiring photographers from across the country, the Vivographers designed and conducted a special masterclass.
It's simply about two aspects: where you stand and when you press the shutter.
A composition is basically the elements that are in your frame and how do you arrange them.
When you are shooting, right, you don't feel what's the best.
You have to go left, right. Don't settle for one good picture. Just keep clicking.
Full of insights on what makes for a great photograph. Tips and tricks on how to improve their art and craft.
Most of these photographs, they're pumped up. They want to do well for the final stage. So we can see even after the masterclass, they are just trying to pick our brains, just asking maybe what we expect and how they can do step up the game.
The masterclasses help them, I would say, believe in themselves a little bit more. They all knew about photography, but they also knew how to write essays. What masterclasses helped them was to put the right punctuation marks so that they can create visual lyrics. It helped them create that visual lyrics so that it becomes a narrative in the form of a picture.
This is the night category, where the world transforms under the cloak of darkness. These photographs capture the magic of nighttime, illuminating cityscapes and the captivating interplay of light and shadow. And the night category, the winner is Sakaram Pavan Kumar.
So we went for the darkest place, looking for the Milky Way shots. And we luckily find some water bodies and Milky Way together. So we are lucky to have the shot.
See the Milky Way, how he has captured it. Not only limiting himself to that, but using light painting and the reflection.
How clear it is. That is the first thing I always look into. I mean, you can see the details. I mean, forget about the Milky Way and the light painting. Can you see the beach as well, right? Those details. And even that Milky Way is straight. I mean, they must have planned in such a way that it's just on top of the head. Even Milky Way angle, the direction also matters in the composition.
So. For me, the way the character was placed there, right in the center, also kind of created that big impact.
There's a light painting going on. You can see the details of the foreground to middle ground to all the way to the sky. That makes a great picture.
And that brings us to the last category, which is motion. These photographs freezes a moment in time, portraying the rush of a city, the grace of a dancer, or the thrill of a race. And it was very well done by Abhishek Patel.
I've always clicked photos on my phone for my own self. It makes to share it on the social media, but getting that photo on the wall, it's like a different feeling for me.
How can you describe motion when at least one element is static?
Static,
exactly.
And he chose that element spot on. You know, when you look at a picture and it has time, it is frozen in time.
Frozen. Yeah.
Simply, if I put it one word, it is life.
There is life. There's a cyclist I can see. There is the Mumbai city, the city that never sleeps, right? It's in complete motion. The scale as well. You can see the scale was amazing. So everything is there, from the motion to architecture. You know, everything is there in one picture.
A big congratulations to all the winners. But it's not just over. It's time for our final category, the Jury's Choice Award. The winner is Shaikat Gupta.
That photograph actually really blew me away, and Kushti is so much a part of Indian culture, and you see that being passed down. But besides that, if you look at it in a particular way, it's the world is upside down. You look at it in one way, it's intergeneration fighting. It's the young trying to assert themselves. And just compositionally, I couldn't take my eyes off it.
So that dynamics in that picture really blew me away. And obviously, across cultures, across age groups, we all believe that we have to pass it on. And I sense that. So very beautiful storytelling, composition, everything worked in that picture.
And then I also like the color. The color palette is very teal and orangey. So it's very pleasing to the eyes.
You know, when I judge every photo, I'll always ask myself, how this could have been better? For this, I don't think he could have chosen a better angle, right? Like the low angle, the perspective is different. Like it ticked all the three, storytelling and the perspective as well as composition. So for me, no, that's a top-notch photo.
It's a big award, and that deserves a round of applause for Shaikat Gupta, everyone.
Today, in the 21st century, when we are all armed with smartphones in our hands, each and every one of us has the power to be a visual storyteller.
As they say, you know, the best camera you have is the one that's in your pocket, and it is your smartphone. You have it with you all the time. It gives you that independence.
When you shoot, you can process on the spot and share it on spot.
Vivo's come up with such good cameras that you really don't have to worry about what cameras you're using. People who didn't believe that they could take pictures, now they're experimenting. And I believe that when you experiment, something good definitely comes up. I would say it's a camera which you can use it as a phone. So that's what Vivo's done it for us.
For us, you know, we are very serious about smartphone photography and we want to take it to another level, you know, because this is just a start and there are learnings which we have drawn from this entire campaign, but the idea is to take it to another level. India is a culturally rich country and we want to enable consumers to capture those moments and store it for the longest of time.
The main takeaway from me is some of the parts of India which I wanted to explore, which I never explored. It's just making me to go now as soon as possible to explore with Vivo phone now.
People sometimes feel like, okay, I look at it and I find it interesting, but nobody else will. And they shouldn't think like that. You know, if you find something interesting, if you see beauty in anything, if you actually see ugliness in something and want to even capture that, please go ahead and do it. Because your point of view is very important. It's how you see the world, it is special.
See, as artists or as photographers, we all, you know, aspire to get that platform where we can showcase our work. We can basically tell our stories. And I think with the Vivo Imagine Awards, that's what happened, because we have social media, obviously, where we post our images and share our stories. But when you see your picture on the wall, you know, it's a different feeling altogether. For a photographer, I feel that is the best feeling.
It was great, actually, and we learned a lot.
To see how people are looking or witnessing moments in a different way helped me. I think in the end, the judges were learning more because there was so much to learn from these images.
For thousands of years, humans have communicated with each other through metaphors and stories. And when expressed through visuals, these stories move our minds and touch our hearts. With the Vivo Imagine campaign, thousands of visual storytellers have expressed the power of their imagination and shared the joy of images with their unique visions. The finest of their work has been celebrated and showcased for the whole world to feast their eyes upon of what the eye can see when it looks through the lens. A grand tribute to the human imagination. Vivo.